We referred Mr. Zabocki to the newsroom. We really did. My next guest is doing pretty well for himself these days. He has a brand new hit album out called The Dream of the Blue Turtles. He's starring in numerous motion pictures, including Plenty and a documentary called Bring on the Night, and he's on a very successful world tour with his brand new band, here performing with Branford Marsalis. My pleasure to welcome Sting.
Hello.
We'll be right back, folks. Nice to see you again.
Nice to be back.
You know, how long ago was you here? 2 years?
I think year and about a half? 2 years, but yeah. It seems like a lifetime.
Does it really? Well, you've accomplished an awful lot. You have the new group, the new album, a handful of motion pictures. By the way, I thought you were really good in Plenty.
Oh, thank you.
Did you enjoy that film?
I had a great time with Meryl Streep.
Yeah.
She's a great actress, but she's great fun off camera.
Now, really? Now, see, she doesn't look to me to be the kind of person that would be fun off camera.
She's hilarious.
I mean, she seems like she would be very, very serious.
That's not true.
She goofs around?
She goofs around.
Give me an example.
Maybe I'm blowing her cool, I don't know.
But she looks like a very serious...
I like actors who can, when the camera's turned off, can relax.
Yeah, because acting, she does that?
Acting is too difficult and too draining to do it all day.
Yeah.
And I think it's great to relax.
Are you two friends now?
Absolutely.
Yeah. But as you and I discussed earlier, the film leaves you with a really kind of a sense of the hopelessness of existence. But I enjoyed that.
It's pretty depressing. I like it.
I was depressed for the next 3 days, but it was a really positive kind of depression.
That's right. Wholesome kind of depression. Yeah. I'm into that.
Let's talk about the film the new film.
Bring on the Night?
Yeah, Bring on the Night. I'm sorry.
It's a documentary, basically.
Yeah, about the formation of the band. Now, you're practicing, you're rehearsing in a huge villa or chateau. Where is that?
It's a chateau. It's about 10 miles outside of Paris.
Yeah.
And the reason we chose that is because it was photogenic and quite cheap to hire. It's quite cheap to hire a chateau because the people who own it can't afford to just keep it as a house, so they let people in.
Uh-huh.
And during the filming, we had old people come in to see the artwork.
As a part of a tour?
As part of a tour, and they got a band for free. They hated it. Mm-hmm. But they got a band.
Now, there's actually a scene in the film where people are unloading out of cars and they're coming up, touring through the house while you guys are rehearsing. Now, did that actually happen?
They were real tourists.
Yeah.
And, you know, they didn't want to see the band, but they wanted to see the artwork around the walls, but they had to deal with us.
Yeah.
It's a very funny scene.
Did you folks live in the chateau the whole time or just rehearse there?
No, we just rehearsed there.
Yeah. I guess we're going to take a look at a few seconds from the film. I want to ask you a question about a guy in white hair. I don't know if he's in this clip. You know a guy in the white hair? In fact, I saw him in the hall.
A guy with white hair?
White hair, longer hair, looks white.
Let's talk about it after the clip.
Okay.
I don't remember.
Okay, we'll see who this guy is. Do we know what we're going to see? We'll talk about it later.
You sing a third, you sing a fifth, I'll sing a tonic. The same with barbed wire, same with bridge, the same with chasm or chasm.
No, chasm.
Chasm. It was chasm yesterday.
Yeah.
And then, on fire.
Just the last word of every line.
The last part around your heart.
Oh, around your heart. Okay.
I'll show you. If I built this fortress around your heart. Now full voice. 1, 2, 3, 4. If I built this fortress around your heart and circled you in trenches and barbed wire. Let's do it. Full ensemble.
1, 2, 3, 4. If I built this fortress around your heart, and circled you in trenches and barbed wire.
Okay, this is from Bring on the Night. And of course, Branford Marsalis, nice to see you. Now, did this bother you guys when you were trying to put together a new group to have a camera crew working pretty much every time you worked?
Yeah.
To get in the way? Was it annoying at all?
We had a real job to do, which was to rehearse a real gig for a real audience at the end of the week.
Absolutely.
And the filmmakers want to do things again and again and again to get it perfect.
Yeah.
We'd already got the music perfect. Yeah. We wanted to move on to the next song.
Now, at one point of the film, somebody refers to you by a name other than Sting, Gordon Sumner. Which is your name?
That's the name I was christened with.
Yeah. Now, does it bother you when people don't call you Sting?
It bothers me in that I think people who call me Gordon think they're being on the inside, you know.
Well, that's what I was thinking.
But no one. No one.
Your mom calls you Sting?
My mom calls me Sting.
How about your kids?
My children call me Sting.
How many children do you have?
I have 4.
Which brings up another interesting point about the film. We have the arrival of number 4
arrives in the movie.
Arrives
by accident, I must say. My fourth child was born right in the middle of filming, and we shot it, and I thought it would be a home movie, but Michael Apted, the director, thought it would be a great idea to have it in the movie with the soundtrack of a song called Russians. And I sat watching it with my girlfriend, and we both wept again because we cried during the birth. And everyone else in the room wept. It's like 20 grown-ups crying with a handkerchief out. And I thought, well, something very profound is happening in this scene, so I left it in the film.
Leave it in and leave the kid in the family.
I just hope he doesn't want to be paid when he gets old enough. You know?
We have to do a commercial. We'll be right back. Branford.
You can't beat it. Just ask any.
Very much for being here. We'll see you tomorrow night. Thanks, Sting. Congratulations.
Saturday, hunters on a mission to
Year.